he didn't expect the car to flavor to jump that much. YouTube, when you watch it, you want to see new things that make you go like, oh. So seeing a guy from India speak Arabic is a big deal, number one. Seeing a guy from India speak Arabic in different accents is a bigger deal, number two. And also can do English accents. So it's like, okay. So if I have these talents, then what do I have to keep it to myself? I kind of like have to present to people and see if it works. So that's where I started doing this language stuff. I started observing people speak and try to get their language and then try to repeat how they speak. And pretty much it worked. So used it. The first video I put up was back in 2014. And that video hit around 300,000 views in like 2 months. That was a big deal for me. So I was like, okay, this works. So let me try this if it works. And it went on from there. That was when I hit 100k last year. Actually, I hit 100k at the beginning of last year. So the thing got deleted because I had changed my YouTube channel name once. So they couldn't review my silver play button eligibility. So I had to contact them and talk to them. And they were like, okay, now we have reviewed and cleared your problems. It'll be at your doorstep in a month. Yeah, that was pretty good. Receiving something from an organization you wouldn't even expect to have someone to talk to, you know, that was a big deal for me. With the cars, as a kid, I would having the Merc wasn't a good idea for racing. I got a lot of heat ups in the car many times because it's an old car and I used to keep like rushing, pushing it with the second gear, third gear, second gear, third. It doesn't really stand that. I was almost about to crash at 180 in the Cruiser. Yeah, that was a race with, I don't remember the car. It was not a big deal, a car, but I think it was a Avalon. It pretty much, it's powerful. Avalon is kind of powerful. So Avalon was going, and imagine 2002 stock Cruiser racing with an Avalon and cutting in the traffic. So it wasn't like an empty road race. So I was racing there, and I realized that day that racing is not a safe thing to do in streets. So kind of restrained from that, but safe racing is fine. So that day I was about to crash into a street light. I lost control almost, and I had to somehow, luckily the car didn't flip. And the car came to a stop after a lot of braking and the tires screeching and everything. But that came to a stop that day. That I realized the danger. Maybe it's a sign from God that said, if you're doing this shit, expect you die, you know, anytime. So please keep stay away from that stuff. Yeah. There's an area called Thurub in Umulkuen, if you know it. That area is actually not supposed to be gone to because it has the... No, it's not haunted. It's not a haunted area. It's about the land that is there. It's connected to the sea. So it looks like hard sand, but underneath it's salt. It's mushy land. So my friends didn't know that it was like that. They thought they found a new drift pad. And they were like, guys, come, we have found a new place. Bring your cars, we can drift. So they're playing around that area. And one guy chose to go deeper inside. He didn't know there was a sea right there. It was like very far away. It wouldn't even be seen. So we went in, he went in. And pretty much after a few minutes, he's stuck. When you're stuck in sand, you can roll your tire. It'll be dry. Here, when you roll your tire, you get the tire mixed with the sand of salt. So you literally sit there and just roll the tires. So two guys got stuck and they called me so that I can pull one out. I went there. I tried to pull. There were like two cars. I pulled out one car. I got stuck. Then one car went out to clear out the tires and come back again so they can pull me out. He got stuck. So three cars stuck. We called a VTC. We called a petrol platinum. We called even a Jeep Wrangler modified. None of them could pull them out because they couldn't reach where we are. So we had to leave the cars there that night and go. And when we left, we were about to leave, we saw cops passing by. We asked them about this place. They're like, it's kind of dangerous. There's a number we can give you. We can call in for rescue. Those cars, they run with light tires. They're like, they look like F1 cars for the rescue. So they charge 500 per car. So we didn't have that kind of money back then. So we're like, we could leave the car here. The next day we got a friend's recovery with a longer winch with the rope attached. He stood a long way. And then we pulled the car one by one out. So leaving the car, the worst part was not leaving the car, because we got to know that the sea could come in. If the sea comes in, it'll take the cars away. So we slept that night with nightmares of my car rolling through to the sea. That was the worst day, because the anxiety that I had that night was incredibly bad. There was actually another video of a drift club which used this song to show the drifting of their cars. So we saw the video and we're like, that music was good. So we're like, why don't we use our cars in that? Which we're like, okay, fine. We'll just do a video of cars rolling normally. And just we'll take shots of the cars like close. No video, no idea of resort was there. Then we came up with a story. Let's make a story of kids growing up with the passion and keeping it going, and then ending up with the kids grown back to adults. So that story came up when a lot of people came together and we worked as a big team. And that video went really well, and it was one of those nice car stuff that we did, which a lot of people enjoyed watching, with the music and the beat dropping exactly at the jump and stuff. That jump was pretty critical for one of the guys in the team. He had his back, didn't get injured, but he didn't expect the car to jump that much. No one knows it. People think that it's a professional driver who did the stunt. No! He thought it would be like, doom, doom, that's it. But he didn't expect to see the sky for 2 seconds, and he landed exactly and then hit his back very hard. He couldn't breathe for a while, but we got the shot. Tire came out, tire popped. Rim bent a little bit, but we continued with the job anyway. Yeah. Okay, the track doesn't have the excitement that you have on the street. Because when you do something that is savage, that is wild, outside the law, it has a different feeling. But the discipline on the track is also fine. It's fun. Because I kind of get the feeling of the legendary racing people who did it on the... They started on the streets too. Every racer had done something on it. Lewis Hamilton has done on the street. Schumacher has done on the street. Verstappen has done on the street. These guys, even bikers, they have done on the streets a lot of things. So, I'm going to be diplomatic here. If street racing becomes illegal, I'll go for street racing. The fun is there. Otherwise, I'll stick to tracks. Yeah. Okay, so the Lamborghini Countach was the thing that made me feel like cars can be designed in different ways. And how do you get into that? How do you get inside that car? That's a big deal. I was like, yeah, this is the car. And I got a poster and I had it up above my bed. And I don't have the paper now. But now Lamborghini-wise, I would actually own... I would like to own an Aventador. Yeah. Study really well. Research before you put your money into cars. Because cars could turn to money pits. They could be the thing that can really swallow your bank account. So when you buy a car, you should really know what you're buying. When you like a car, you should know why you like it. Never like a car because someone told you, this is amazing. Never do that. You might hear and you might be impressed, but never put your money into cars that will give you temporary happiness. A car is a commitment. A car is determination. It's passion. So if you don't have these three, don't get into it. Stay away. This channel is important, you know why? Because it's controlled by people who know things. And it's not a fancy vlog channel where people just look for the fancy stuff. Here you're gonna be having long talks, long exposure of car stuff, like mechanical things and dirty things. And that'll give you a backstory of how these cars, the incredible cars you see on other vlogs, are made. Thank you for having me. Hope you like this interview of mine. And if you are watching this video, if you're watching me right now, you're lucky to listen to my stories. If you didn't like my stories, I don't give a damn.